I could say it was gonna get better. I'm moving on.
Yeah, we were the very first animal ever sold here. It was a heifer that made about $1,800, I think, and that was all donated to Lifeline. That first sale was a big job, and it by was no means flawless, but they got there in the end, and they just didn't know what was coming, basically, and they got through it. It's grown bigger and better ever since.
Well, the first sale, as everyone remembers, was a nightmare from the start. Everyone wanted to be part of it, and we probably jammed in too many cattle for the first sale. I remember, like, we were selling at the sale, then going home, get horses to help them deliver. But the way it's worked out now, they put the weighbridge in, and it just runs smoothly. Oh, the teething, it's like anything. You can still improve things as you go along. It's like anything. If you don't think you've got everything right, that's when you stop learning.
Absolute disaster. I think the first sale, we didn't finish weighing until some stupid time on, I think, nearly Thursday. So thank goodness since then we've ironed out most of the problems, and it's a lot smoother than what it was the first sale.
Absolute chaos. I think, unfortunately, everyone wanted to be a part of it. And so we had probably a too big a number to start with just to trial it. But we've got through that. There's always teething issues with any new venture. And I think we've probably been the first facility like this, and we've got through it, and I think we've helped other people when they've built the other sale yards. We've helped them.
It's had a massive impact. It's our business has grown enormously over the last decade, from where we were. A combination of joining Ray White as well and merging with Paddy Bird up at Oberon. But CTLX has been, it's been the best thing that's ever happened for our agency and for our clients, as far as I'm concerned.
To get it all congregated here in Carcor under one roof has been fantastic, especially logistics-wise. And it's been a win-win, really, for everybody.
It's in a lot of ways, it's really resurrected our business. I was part of the orange selling organisation, and we were ever so slowly dying on the vine there through lack of support and numbers of stock drifting away to major centres such as Forbes and Dubbo. This has stopped the rot completely, being a major selling centre in New South Wales.
CT Alex has been very good for our business. It's probably made us be able to expand a little more to the west outside of Bathurst. The business was just based in Bathurst and Oberon in the earlier days, and selling out here at Carcor has probably given us a bit of scope to push to the west a little bit, and just purely the numbers that get put through these yards give you a little bit more draw from a wider area.
Yeah, it's been absolutely great. We're one of the founding members here at Clemmis McCarthy. We've been here since day dot, and it's been a great outlet for Clemmis McCarthy to be able to sell sheep and lambs and cattle, fat cattle and store cattle in the one centre.
Well, I suppose for our business, considering we were mainly based in the west out of Forbes since the 80s, I suppose it's helped our business develop into the eastern side of the Tablelands. And I suppose it's helped our business grow a fair bit more from where it was.
Now we've got the one sale for each on two different days. It starts at 9, which has just recently happened, and we've got numbers by 10:30, 11 at the latest. Our trucks generally are loaded and gone before dark. And fatigue-wise, the rules that have come in the last, since Carcor's opened, really, we wouldn't have been able to do it without Carcor opening.
We had a major impact on our business, because now we've got the CTLX, we're getting a more consistent team of buyers coming, and also it's attracting a larger number of lambs, which attracts a larger number of buyers, especially in the springtime when the big sucker runs are on. We get outside influence, which it keeps our lamb prices pretty firm.
Made it a lot simpler. Got all the cattle in the one area, whereas we used to have pick up from three different sale yards. We were a bit sceptical at first about it because we were so used to having the sale yards right on our doorstep. So we were a bit worried about it being so far away, but it's worked out very good. It's actually lightened our effort here.
Look, I think we enjoy selling at CTLX because it's a very good facility to work in. Particularly the cattle yards, it's amazing how many numbers you can put through there and be out of here and home in bed at a pretty reasonable time, which is always nice. But it's been a very good place to work in. I've worked in a fair few sale yards across the country, and this is certainly up there with the best of them to handle stock in, that's for sure.
I just really enjoy the work. I love being around livestock and working with all the agents. They're pretty good guys.
I think the competition in regards to the other agents that we're up against, I think when we were in Bathurst there was 5 agents. I think we're up to 10 or 12 agents now, sort of thing. So definitely the competition against the other agents.
For me, I came from a Canamble, which was a sale yards that was out in the open, not undercover, cement underneath, and I've come here to where I'm undercover all the time. I've got soft floors. It's better for me, it's better for the stock, and it's a lot better for my staff and the buyers who come and attend on.
The regional centre gets a lot of cattle and sheep here, which attracts more buyers, and alternatively, better prices for the clients.
The volume and the great support from the buying fraternity, the volume of numbers and the support from buyers that brings.
It doesn't actually feel like work, just enjoy my job and yeah.
The biggest undercover roof space, it's ease of working in.
Not much not to like about a facility like this, and if you wind the clock back about 25 years ago, people were calling sale yards as a dead entity, you know, they'll be defunct. And Carcor has actually proved that very, very wrong.
I like working with livestock, and I like working with the people that come to CTLX each day.
I guess probably from a bull breeding perspective, my best moments is when I see calves by my bulls here selling well and making good money for their clients. You get a real buzz out of that, and that's one thing that we've been able to do with this extra competition and bigger yardings and more money.
So you said, what was the funniest thing I can remember for the 10 years here? The one thing that does stand out as a funny moment was when Cliff Willis got run arse over head by a cow and did his knee in. And the most deliberate act was Scott Johnson when he opened the gate to let the cow out onto him.
My funniest moment would probably listen to Steve Mooney talk about how he's God's gift to women most weeks would be probably my funniest moment.
Yeah, well, I had a bit of a run-in with a certain sheep buyer here one day that started to tell me how I should be doing my business and so forth. So I've got to admit I lost my cool a little bit, so I threw him my keys and told him if he could do it, the job any better than me, he's welcome to it. So he caught my keys. It was a wonderful catch, and all he did, he managed to throw them as far as he could across the sheepyard. So I was without keys for a couple of hours. But anyway, we solved our differences and we get along very well together now.
It's been a hell of a 10 years, guys. Couldn't have done it without agents, vendors, transporters, buyers, and of course, my staff. Let's bring on the next 10 years.